Got me reminiscing back to when days were great. Got me wishing it was 1988.
Got me reminiscing back to when times were great. Got me wishing it was 1988.
Welcome, Lime Nation. It's great to have you back for the January edition of the Rap Flashback, your monthly dose of hip-hop history. With the holidays in the rear view and New Year's resolutions in full effect, January comes with both a stigma of having to get back to reality and a renewed sense of excitement for whatever the new year may hold. With that in mind, let's dive right in and explore some choice hip-hop moments from the Januaries of yesteryear. The Fat Boys released their second album, The Fat Boys Are Back, on January 19th in 1985. Featuring the title track as its standout, the smooth, melodic bass lines that layer the album are complemented nicely with vintage, old-school big beat drums and, of course, the legendary beatboxing skills of the late, great Big Buff Love, aka the human beatbox. Often underappreciated and at times written off as more than just a novelty act, the Fat Boys, who along with Buffy, were flanked by the high energy and above average MC skills of Kool Rock Ski and Prince Mikey D, built a strong following with their debut and kept the momentum going with this record. It peaked at number 11 on the R&B and hip-hop charts on its way to gold certification. They went on to release 5 more albums through the early 90s and even landed and starred in their own film, 1987's Disorderlies, a goofy comedy starring the Fat Boys as dysfunctional orderlies, or disorderlies, if you will, hired to take care of an old rich guy. Hilarity ensues.
You guys kill me. Another night like this and I'll die.
You can't die, Albert. If you die, we'll lose this job.
On January 21st, 1985, hip-hop's first supergroup, Run-DMC, released their second studio album, King of Rock, a true classic. Also utilizing the big beat drums that were typical of mid-80s rap. It sees the group employ more rock and roll type sounds, such as heavy guitar riffs, most notably on the album's title track, an all-time great in its own right. Other standout tracks include You Talk Too Much, a funny track where both Run and DMC wax poetic on people with big mouths who, to quote the track, never shut up, and Jam Master Jammin', a song that showcases the DJ skills of the late great Jam Master Jay. The album peaked at number 12 on the R&B and hip-hop charts and further established Run-DMC's mid-80s dominance. Too Short has a couple of notable January milestones as he released his second studio album, Life Is Too Short, on January 31st, 1988, and his sixth, Cocktails, on January 24th, 1995. Featuring his trademark Pimps and Hoes flow, as only Too Short could deliver, Life Is Too Short became his highest-selling album to date, amassing double platinum sales. While not as successful as its January predecessor, Cocktails debuted at number 6 on the Billboard 200 on its way to platinum status. I vividly remember bumping this title track a lot back in the day, as its smooth, hypnotic beat blended nicely with Too Short's XXX rated storytelling. Truly one of Oakstown's finest, listening to Too Short always makes me feel kinda pimpish. Gangstar released their second studio album, Step in the Arena, on January 15th, 1991. Selected as one of the best 100 hip-hop albums of all time by The Source magazine in 1998, the album features Guru's trademark smooth but powerful vocals over DJ Premier's sample-driven production. Gangstar's style was often a jazz-rap fusion that's prevalent on this record. It peaked at number 19 on the R&B and hip-hop charts and featured 4 singles that ranked at number 11 or better on the Hot Rap Singles chart, including the title track and Just to Get a Rap, both of which peaked at number 5. Shoutouts to one of the most legendary duos in rap history, and rest in power to Guru, a truly remarkable lyricist who sadly all too often flies under the radar. Boston, stand up.